Let's Sing 2020, a review that you've been all asking for. Yeah, I think it's time to review this fabulous interactive singing game that I have mastered in my last 3 weekends. After a bottle of lemonade, I just feel my vocal cords let loose and the Mick Jagger inside me wants to wake up. I even reached the maximum level yesterday and totally lost my voice later in the evening. I had to whisper to communicate with my cats and my girlfriend. But it was worth it. Maximum level! To be honest, I'm not 100% today either. Anyways, let's get down to business. Let's Sing 2020 is a similar game to SingStar. It's basically a competitive music video game that lets you really know if you are as good of a singer you think to be. In most cases, it reveals the opposite, considering that there is no match for me in online servers, but I'll come to that. The aim of the game is simple, to sing and hold your notes. The correct notes, I mean. That is how the game measures your score. By singing and holding the correct notes, you will be rewarded with points. Some notes are marked with yellow star and a golden glow. These notes give you score multipliers. It can go as high as 5 times. I've noticed that the game doesn't punish you for messing up the words as long as you sing them in tune or, you know, in tune to the song. Which is wonderful, because even though the game provides you with the right lyrics, I find it hard to read and listen to the music at the same time. Some of my highest scores are composed of my own gibberish, but nevertheless worthy of victory. I mean, singing the part of Sean Paul, No Lie, with Dua Lipa is some high-grade shiznitz on its own. Impossible with my English, trust me. So this game can be used as a karaoke machine as well. But you need to take into consideration that those songs are not instrumental, meaning that you need to sing along with the original artist. Hence, you have the option to listen yourself, if you are in the right key, with your cacophony. A mixture of sounds that shouldn't be playing at the same time. But the question is, how do I sing? Does my console microphone work? Well, there are several ways you can get your voice synchronized with Let's Sing 2020. First, you can buy or reuse some of the microphones made for SingStar for PlayStation 3. Those are totally compatible. I use these because, firstly, I got them from very cheap price from a random dude in my parking lot. And one of them is slightly damaged, but it works. It works as good as ever. And secondly, when I sing, I get right on the high horse of a contemptuous rockstar mindset. I hold on to this magical stick of vocal wonders and scream away in the symphony of modern pop songs. But there is also a possibility to sing using your mobile phone. Firstly, download the Let's Sing microphone app for your smartphone for your chosen console platform. Then connect your smartphone to the same internet connection as your console. Then launch the game first and then the Let's Sing microphone app to connect the app to your console. Once connected, choose your song and sing away. The app is both for Android and iOS users. Now, there are several game modes for you to attempt. Firstly, this classical mode, where you can just, you know, let loose and choose your own favorite song and sing along. There can be 4 players connected at the same time, singing at the same time. A horrible idea, if you ask me. Then, you can sing a duet with your partner and discover your compatibility. Then there is mixtape, where you can select your 5 favorite songs and the game randomly selects parts of those and sticks them in front of you without any warning. So Elton John can turn into Queen in a second, and getting your voice ready and breath in between is a rare luxury. Now, as I discovered, this game mode is the devil himself, as it crashes every 3rd game. It freezes in time like Bono's face. You know. I had to restart my console at least 7 times in 1 evening, so I would stay clear of this mixtape mode. But as you relax your vocal cords, since they are probably tired, you can listen to your favorite songs with the jukebox option, or get into the party mode. This option is basically governed by different rules. You can form 2 groups of your besties and battle against each other or AI. There are different challenges in it, and so on. But this game mode struggled to start as I was recording. And you know, if you feel frisky, you can always go online. My favorite Let's Sing World Contest, where you'll be able to go head to head or mouth to mouth with your fellow singers or random randies from all over the globe. There are usually 5 to 6 opponents with different levels and songs for you to choose from. Either way, it feels challenging. And as I discovered, I'm rather good. I have not lost a single game yet. And as I surprised even myself how well I was doing, even without the correct words, I still aced it. I can't even imagine other people at their home seeing that I sometimes score 4 times as many points as they are. My strong plays are Aha, Take On Me and Tears of Fears, Mad World, because it suits my vocal preset the best. Also, somehow Queen, Show Must Go On is one that I really feel comfortable singing. Amazing, me and Queen, didn't see that one coming, eh? So the list of songs, although intimidating at first, is small, about 20 songs. Here is the list of all of them. Sadly, you know, I can't let you hear them for obvious reasons. But you can buy more. There are about 7 packs, £4 per pack. Or you can purchase them all at once for 25 quid. Every pack holds about 5 songs and, well, for this review, I bought most of them. Well, okay. Okay. I will admit that I bought them because I seem to be a singaholic. A closet singaholic. A closet singaholic. Still, let me consolidate all my arguments, both good and bad. Lots of fun with very close friends who you can open your vocal cords to without any shame. A nice music-driven evening with very competitive vibes, but also very limited due to the amount of fearless people I know. And the songs just, you know, are too few of those songs. For £65, or $78, or €69, you get 60 songs. You know, we will go through them really fast. I also discovered that you can buy artist-specific editions of this game, like Let's Sing Queen for extra $39.99. You can pretend to be one of the greatest vocal heroes ever lived. By the way, I am going to buy this. But as you can see, this game quickly adds up. There's also this country music edition, and you know. So it's your decision where you spend and how. But it's still expensive, you know, that's a minus for me. For me, this game is a nice time for Friday evening and almost ranks up near Beat Saber and Guitar Hero. I give Let's Sing 2020 a 7.5 out of 10. Even if you hate singing, I hope that you enjoyed this review. If you did, hit that like, smash that bell, and if you dare, subscribe as well. I'm Sillyllamaz, and thanks for watching. Till next time!